Now, an implication. If P, then Q can be written in several ways. The form if P, then Q. P implies Q. Q if P. Q whenever P. Or Q provided that P. So new definition. Now, given an implication, there are three related statements. The converse of an implication, P implies Q, is the statement Q implies P. The contrapositive of an implication, P implies Q, is the statement not Q implies not P. And the inverse of an implication, P implies Q, is the statement not P implies not Q. So new definition. A statement of the form P if and only if Q is called an equivalence or biconditional statement and is denoted this way with a double-headed arrow, a biconditional is true precisely when the statement P and the statement Q have the same truth values, so let's look at the truth table for a biconditional. Once again, a biconditional is true when both the prime statements P and Q have the same truth value. So when both are true, the biconditional is true, and when both are false, the biconditional is true, and in all other cases, the biconditional is false. Now, in written form, the phrase if and only if is abbreviated IFF, and a definition whether stated as such or not is always a biconditional statement. So let's look at a definition. A statement that is true in all cases is called a tautology. And a statement that is false in all cases is called a contradiction. Notice that in this definition, the statements are not explicitly biconditional statements, but again, a definition is always a biconditional statement, whether stated as such or not. A tautology is equivalent to a statement that is true in all cases, and a contradiction is equivalent to a statement that is false in all cases. So, new definition. Two statements composed of the same prime statements are logically equivalent if and only if their truth tables are identical. Or, equivalently, if and only if the biconditional joining them is a tautology. So notice that in this definition, the definition is stated explicitly as a biconditional statement. So let's look at an example. The biconditional P if and only if Q is logically equivalent. That's the symbol I'll use for logical equivalence. The implication P implies Q, and the implication Q implies P, that is the conjunction of the implication and its converse. So let's look at the truth table. Now the implication P implies Q is false only when P is true and Q is false, and is true in all other cases. The implication Q implies P is false only when Q is true and P is false, and is true in all other cases. So if we now look at the conjunction of the implication and its converse, we have true and true is true, false and true is false, true and false is false, true and true is true. And with the biconditional is true when P and Q have the same truth values, and is false otherwise. So notice that the conjunction of the implication and its converse and the biconditional had the same or identical truth table. Equivalently, we can look at the biconditional joining these two statements. Since the two statements always have the same truth values, the biconditional joining these two statements is a tautology. So as an exercise, show that an implication P implies Q is logically equivalent to its contrapositive, not Q implies not P, and that the converse Q implies P is logically equivalent to the inverse, not P implies not Q. So let's look at some examples using negation. We will show that the negation of a conjunction is logically equivalent to the disjunction of the negations. So again, we construct a truth table. Now, the conjunction is true only when both P and Q are true, and so the negation of the conjunction is false when both P and Q are true and is true otherwise. So now we look at the disjunction of not P and not Q. So if we negate P and Q, we have false or false, which is false, false or true, which is true, true or false, which is true, and true or true, which is true. So once again, the two statements have identical truth tables. Or looking at the biconditional joining them, since we have the same truth values, or since both statements have the same truth values in all cases, we have that the biconditional is true in all cases, and so this is a tautology. So now we'll look at the negation of a disjunction and show that this is logically equivalent to the conjunction of the negations. Now the disjunction is false only when both P and Q are false, and so for the negation we have that the negation of the disjunction is true when both P and Q are false and is false otherwise. So if we now look at the conjunction of the negation of P with the negation of Q, we have false and false is false, false and true is false, true and false is false, and true and true is true. Two statements have identical truth tables, or equivalently, looking at the biconditional, the two statements have the same truth values in all cases, and so this is a tautology. So now we'll look at the negation of an implication and show that this is logically equivalent to the conjunction of the hypothesis P with the negation of the conclusion Q. Now the implication is false only when P is true and Q is false. And so negating the implication, we have that when P is true and Q is false, the negation is true. And in all other cases, it is false. So now we look at P and not Q. So we have true and false, which is false, true and true, which is true, false and false, which is false, and false and true, which is false. Again, the two statements have identical truth tables, or equivalently, looking at the biconditional joining the two statements, The two statements always have the same truth values. And so this is a tautology.